That's not good. That's not good. It's moving. It's moving. It is cracking so much.
When Tesla started making the Cybertruck, they invented something called the Gigapress, which is the world's largest 9,000-ton aluminum injection molding machine that can effectively make Cybertruck frames out of aluminum within minutes. Very impressive. However, when it comes to enabling truck stuff like towing, it sounds like Tesla just took a steel receiving hitch and bolted it straight to that cast aluminum frame. Which raises some eyeballs after Whistle and Diesel's hitch completely separated from his truck during one of his videos. He's also not the only one who's had his hitch completely fall off while towing. So today we're going to scientifically see at exactly what weight the Cybertruck hitch actually breaks off. Or if it really was the fault of the brutal impact that Whistle and Diesel's truck received before it snapped. I don't know exactly what's going to happen, but we do have a Cybertruck and a 50,000-pound excavator, and we will see which one breaks first. I do know, however, that casted aluminum is more porous than, say, extruded aluminum or steel. So if I had to guess, I would say that the Cybertruck is probably cooked. However, we do have a control truck over there. It's a Dodge 2500. It has a steel frame and nearly the same towing capabilities as the Cybertruck, so we can get a direct comparison on how the two materials perform, aluminum or steel. And of course, the bullet hole from one of our previous experiments should not affect the outcome of this scientific experiment. Someone else who's been experimenting with different materials is Ridge Wallets, the sponsor of today's video and the maker of the wallet that I've had in my own pocket for the last 6 years. They just released a new wallet design with built-in internal magnets, making it MagSafe compatible, meaning the wallet securely connects to your iPhone or MagSafe-enabled protective grip case. Incredibly cool. My own Ridge Wallet that's lasted me for half a decade so far is made from titanium. You can see the difference in finish after 6 years of use. Fun fact, titanium was actually floated as a material to plate the Cybertruck with before they settled on stainless steel. If titanium isn't your jam though, Ridge has over 50 other colors and styles to choose from. The wallet holds 12 cards plus cash. You don't have to take my word for it though, Ridge has sold over 5 million wallets over the past 10 years. You can get one for yourself at ridge.com/jerryrig and use the code jerryrig to get up to 40% off of their anniversary sale right now. The rain is coming down. We're still doing this test regardless though. ridge.com/jerryrig and huge thanks to Ridge for supporting my science experiments. We're trying not to disturb the construction workers too much, but they have agreed to let us borrow their excavator. This is such a cool project. To accurately quantify how much pressure is being applied to the hitch, we have something called a crane scale that is normally, you know, supposed to be used on a crane to tell how heavy the load is. In our case though, we've parked the Cybertruck on a ledge and created a custom hitch that holds the scale while we press down on it with an excavator. And we will just keep on pushing until something breaks. The scale will probably break at 20,000 pounds, but I think that the aluminum casting on the Cybertruck will break long before that. We'll make sure to have cameras set up on this. It's accurate to within 5 pound intervals, so we will get a very, very exact number if the Cybertruck breaks. Since the Cybertruck has a towing capacity of 11,000 pounds, I think if we see the hitch snap off before that, before 11,000 pounds, Tesla has a rather large problem on their hands. Since an improperly loaded trailer or a trailer hitting a pothole at 80 miles an hour could distribute those loads on the hitch. If the hitch of the Cybertruck snaps off between, say, 11,000 and 15,000 pounds, I don't think Tesla has an immediate problem on their hands. However, they might have a problem down the road since aluminum does not have a fatigue limit. It will just continuously get weaker and weaker forever, especially as it gets stressed from towing. Not that people who buy Cybertrucks are gonna be towing on a regular basis, but still, it's a truck. It's implied that it can do truck things. Steel, on the other hand, does not have a fatigue limit. So when we test the Dodge over there, it's a 1994, and it is probably just as strong today as it was 30 years ago. Anyway, that's a whole lot of talking, and now it's finally time to start testing. Let's get the excavator over here. Because we're putting so much weight on the back of the Cybertruck, we're nervous that the front of the Cybertruck might come off the ground. So we're using the other tractor to strap in and keep the front tires pinned to the mud. Moment of truth, we got the excavator attached to our custom hitch and scale. We're gonna start applying pressure. All right, it's go time. Go for it.
just a little by little. We're at 70, 100. This is terrifying. 300, 6. I'm scared. Oh my gosh. Okay, so right now we are officially at the, we are exceeding the tongue weight. We are 15, 3,000. 4,000. So far, so good.
Our rear suspension is slammed.
Yeah, it is sinking. Oh, I'm terrified, dude. Oh. You can hear the front end of the truck. Do you hear something?
Yeah.
I hear something happening at 6,000 pounds.
It's not straight anymore.
It's definitely not straight. Dude, 67, that was a crack. Dude, my heart is racing, man. Oh, this is not good. That's not good, that's not good. It's moving. It's moving. The alarm's going off. 8,000. The excavator's over there up on its tracks. We might have him get a little closer so we can put more than 8,000 on it. But man, the truck is creaking. Creaking more than a millennial going downstairs. All right, we're gonna position the excavator a little closer so we can get more of the 50,000 pounds on that hitch. But 8,000 pounds, that's farther than I thought it was gonna get. I thought we were gonna break sub 5. See any damage yet?
It all looks fine.
It's just kinked?
The hitch is back to straight, basically.
All right, that's not bad.
Boy, they handled a little more than we thought.
Yeah, so far the aluminum's doing good.
Got 8,000.
Yeah, it's not bad at all. I thought it would break at like 4 or 5. Round 2. I still think there's a big issue if it breaks under 10. Oh my gosh, dude, it is moving. 9,000 pounds. Oh my gosh. Oh, dude. 10,000.
10,000.
Dude. It is cracking so much. Oh, dude! Oh! That was right at 10,000. Oh my gosh. Ah, oh, dude. 10,000 pounds. Dude, that's wild.
Yeah, that took the whole frame with it.
10,000 pounds. That's Issy. That is one improperly loaded trailer away from catastrophic failure. What do you think about that, dude?
I think you're crazy.
You're not wrong. Okay, let's figure out what happened here. Why besides the obvious that we did this. Yeah, well, you know, that's Tesla. Was this glued?
Yeah, I think that was glued.
All right, so they glued that part together. All right, so let's assess the damage here. So right here, it looks like this casting broke. This is where that was bolted to. So this, what do you think this is, the purple stuff?
It's just like an adhesive.
But it's gotta be a temporary adhesive, right? Like there's no way that was
That
like,
is how they build their cars.
What the freak?
Watch no, on. It's
that
just,
whole
it's just,
thing is held on with the adhesive.
So there's adhesive here.
But I think it's just to line it up.
Dude, we totally jacked this up too. So this might've been like one of the previous cracks. And then like this crack right here, that's the giga casting. The steel hitch is here bolted to the aluminum, but it's the aluminum casting that broke off the face of the truck. Which like I'm pretty sure is the exact same place that it broke on Whistlin Diesel's truck. Obviously his had the impact first and then he yoinked it, but 10,000 pounds where it breaks is not a good thing.
Well, should I just pull forward?
Is it still gonna drive?
I think we just break this off and call it good. It says high voltage system error detected.
Oh no, it's not gonna drive.
Electrical system is unable to support all features.
Can you put it into drive?
Let's find out. It's not letting me drive.
Oh no. I think we broke the truck. It's not even driving anymore. The Cybertruck has 23 different error messages on the screen right now, so we're just gonna drag it out of the way. It said something wrong with the high voltage pack, which like, you know, we ripped off the hitch. Oh my gosh. We still have the steel frame Dodge Ram 2500 to test out here in a second, but the Cybertruck's aluminum castings being glued together is not something I had on my 2025 bingo card. To be fair, it is important here that we mention there is a difference between tongue weight and trailer weight. Normally, while you're towing, you want the trailer weight to carry 90% of your load, and only 10 to 15% of that load resting on that tongue or ball of your hitch.
However, there are real-world situations where the Cybertruck's trailer weight becomes tongue weight while operating under normal towing conditions, like cresting a steep hill or driveway. That 11,000 pounds of trailer weight becomes tongue weight, and the Cybertruck hitch could snap off. Or pulling another vehicle out of a mud pit while off-roading, or off of a tall obstacle like Whistle and Diesel did. Both situations can easily apply 10,000 pounds of force non-linearly. Or worst case scenario, your 11,000 pound trailer jumps the ball while driving on the freeway at 80 miles an hour, and gives the safety chains a sharp downward jerk, and the whole rear end of your Cybertruck is now gone, safety clips included. The truck is now totaled, getting 28 different error messages just because the bumper ripped off is wild. A cast aluminum frame with 3/16 wall thickness is just a slap in the face to anyone who bought one of these Cybertrucks. Thinly cast aluminum is not enough to hold an 11,000 pound trailer in all conditions, and I'm curious to see how Tesla's gonna make this right. The Cybertruck is not a rigid stainless steel exoskeleton super truck like it was advertised. It's a soft, supple, porous Mohs 3-level cast aluminum with the towing ability of a pop can. But we do still have one test left, a normal truck with its steel hitch bolted to a steel bumper.
This one's actually already a little bit bent, so it makes me nervous. It's a 2004 Dodge Ram 2500. Oh, they're twins, they match. Yeah, there's no engine in this one, so it's just the frame and the hitch is what we're testing.
It's pulling it back a little bit.
Right there. So one thing I do want to point out with this truck though is that it's been in a wreck, and it looks like the hitch is already slightly pre-bent. Just want to point that out. We don't know how that's going to affect the actual downward force, but if steel is in fact so much better than aluminum, it might not affect it at all. There's only one way to find out. You know how it is. Okay, let's do it. His tracks are coming off the ground.
Whoa! There you go.
Look at his tracks, dude. I don't know if the excavator can do more weight than that. Not breaking at 10,000 pounds is good. He's got as much weight as he possibly can. The back of the excavator is. We need heavier machines. He's bouncing at 10.7, but it's still not breaking. Do we have any heavier equipment? Let's just bounce it.
Bounce it, he says.
Look at that. Whoa. So it looks like with our current situation, we can't get over 10,000 pounds on this hitch. He's bouncing on it hard. But where the Cybertruck broke, the Dodge is not breaking. I wish we could get some more weight on it though. We are fresh out of construction equipment.
Got that truck over there pinning the front. He's bouncing on it. Holy smokes. I mean, that does go to show that at least this hitch on the steel frame is stronger.
I was hoping that we'd be able to get more weight and figure out when the steel frame would break, but we've maxed it out with the equipment we have available. And the steel frame on the Dodge truck did not break at the same weight that the Cybertruck did break, which is interesting and scientific information, but I do wish we could get a catastrophic failure point on the steel frame. It's just not gonna happen today. Either way, I still have the opinion that a steel frame is much stronger than cast aluminum. And if I see a Cybertruck towing on the freeway, I would not want to be anywhere close to that thing. Especially because an improperly loaded trailer hitting a pothole could put that much weight, 10,000 pounds, onto the hitch and have it snap off.
Not only just snap off, but snap off with its little safety hooks as well. So the trailer, whatever trailer you have, you know, your $100,000 RV is gonna be skittering down the road by itself because there's nothing left holding it to the Cybertruck. Wild.
You know what doesn't break though? A Ridge wallet. Get up to 40% off with the link in the description.
That's that. Let me know what your thoughts are down in the comments, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.